great. The more seats.
Which were lovely. I don't want to add to what we're going to play, which is so beautiful. Just give the orchestra time to rearrange. We're playing now two movements from Bizet, Suite Carmen. You may have heard of that opera. Beautiful stuff. And the first, the flute solo will be played by Margot Hornet. We did not put that in the program, but she will stay in your hearts.
Thank you.
Next on the program is Quelle surprise. It is because we thought we would keep this piece a little bit of a surprise for you. The accurate information is contained in the arrangement's name, Trent Worthington, who is who did a marvelous job of a tune that we will perform for you. It's called Viva la Vida. It's by Coldplay, all the composers of which are still alive. Yeah. So, I know. Background behind it, the words are supposed to depict the pre-dying Louis XVI, who some purport, although it has not been proven historically, was trying to give a speech to his people just in minutes before he was about to be executed. So he was talking, but everybody was yelling and was thirsting for his blood that nobody could hear in the intended audience what he was saying. So it's kind of a pathetic end to a royal life. There's a duality to this song by Coldplay, which is that also is famous painting by Frida Kahlo from 1950s called it's not called anything, but it's a seven pieces of a watermelon. It's a stunning painting by a fantastic, stunning artist who at age 18 ended up in a horrible car accident and suffered from a tremendous back pain her entire life. But she still found it fitting to write it, to paint in the middle bottom of the painting on the most prominently looking watermelon, Viva la Vida. So there is a great message and for life and the strength of life, which we will attempt to communicate. We will perform this with the Madrigal Singers and the concert choir today. So this is a joint event. We hope you enjoy it.